What do you think about the new League of Legends fighting game name? 2XKO? I don't know who's working at Riot that came up with this name, but they need to be put in a different department. That is probably the worst game name I've ever seen, and I don't say that lightly. So if any of you have been following Riot's projects, you'll know that they had Project L, which is their 2v2 fighter, which actually looks like a hype game. They've officially announced that it's called 2XKO, which I think is crazy. That's a terrible name. Like, even if they took the X out, I think that could work. If they just called it 2KO, that's kind of cool. Like, that flows. 2XKO? Nah, this looks like the start to some kind of Xbox Live Arcade code. It's stupid. It's like a captcha. Yeah, even Project L was a better name. This shit sounds like a hentai doujin. I'm not a huge hentai guy, but I'll take your word for it. All I know is it's a bad name. When will you review Avatar? I'm gonna try and finish it tomorrow. So I might have a review up for it tomorrow. Hey, thanks for that, Anthony. I did see the Borderlands trailer. Speaking of Stinky, I didn't love the Borderlands trailer. Visually, I thought there were some very cool moments in it, but that's about like the best compliment I have. The rest is kind of shaky, and it's hard to say if it's gonna be like good or bad. But I can say the visuals in it looked pretty decent. Everything else, we'll see. Thanks, Risa Mashton. It looks like they wanted James Gunn to direct it so bad. That's a good point. It does feel like someone was trying to imitate James Gunn. Yeah, I would agree with that. And not really cock. I guess in Teen Titans. Thanks, Resub Stab. And yeah, I did see it, Stab. Randy Pitchford said this movie is going to start the Borderlands cinematic universe. Is Randy Pitchford still there? I thought I. Re this could be a Mandela effect, but I thought I remembered him resigning at some point. Is he still the CEO at Gearbox? Yeah. Well, no. Yeah. No. No, it looks like he's still got his post. God damn, Ethan, you've been so fucking generous tonight. Thank you so much for that, man. And yeah, I probably will try and get the lore before it drops. A new Borderlands game would be very welcome. Need to scratch that itch. Yeah, but that itch hasn't been scratched since Borderlands 2, man. I didn't really like 3 that much, and I couldn't stand Tiny Tina's Wonderland. I have not seen Argyle. You know if it's based on any of the games or completely separate? Well, just by watching the trailer, I can 100% assure you it is completely separate. Yeah. It takes the vibe of the games more so than anything. Yeah, Randy Pitchford was the guy. Only real gamers remember this. Randy Pitchford was the guy who left a flash drive of porn at a medieval times restaurant, and someone found it. And then, in order to explain why he had a bunch of like cam model porn on his flash drive, he said that the reason that was there is because he was studying the squirting method that the girl used because he thought it was a magic trick. For those that don't know, Randy Pitchford's grandfather basically invented magic tricks. Like, he was a prolific magician. So his excuse was, I wasn't masturbating to this. I was watching her squirt to learn how she does it because there's so much liquid. Like, he couldn't imagine like all of that fluid being anything more than a magic trick that he was trying to crack. It was an incredible excuse. That's cute, Anthony. That was back. When was that? It was in 2019, man. How time flies. It was a huge controversy. Obviously, there was more to it than just like the porn, but that was such a wacky part of it. The wet wizard. Now, this man was hot on the case. Thanks, Reese Buzz, and the prime syrup. How the fuck did people know it was his? Well, I think the comment right above yours is accurate based on memory. It was brought in as evidence when Sega sued them for mishandling funds. It was so, like, it was more than, they weren't in a legal battle over Randy Pitchford being a sexual degenerate or anything. But that came up because it was used as evidence at some point. I don't remember exactly why, it's just been too long. Who carries a USB of porn? That's what I said. Even in 2019, that's like really archaic. And especially to bring it to a medieval times to, I don't know, I guess, have a jelk session at the medieval times, eat a turkey leg, and watch some cam models squirt. It's certainly odd. Haven't finished the Avatar Netflix show yet. And thanks for the gifted member, Goofus. Not yet, Bricks. I haven't started the documentary. I still have it queued up. As the kings of old once did. Ah, yes. Just like our ancestors. He's the prime boss. Dude, people download porn and need somewhere to store that. I mean, what, you could just keep it on your computer. I don't know why it needs to go mobile. Unless you're just like such a brain-rotted coomer that you have to have your porn on you at all times like a rabbit's foot. You can absolutely just keep it at home. Where it should be. Things that resub imagine. I'm also gonna say, I don't know if this is a hot take. Downloading porn, that also feels like really ancient. I don't know anyone that does, but I see a lot of like porn addicts that are like, oh, it's totally normal, like everyone does that. Yeah, chat's kind of split on that. More on the side of, yeah, I don't know anyone that downloads either. It just feels like that's like an early 2000s thing, when that was the only way to access it. I doubt he still goes to the medieval times, Bricks. He's probably been blacklisted from attending medieval times anymore. I don't think they'd allow him back in there, unless he goes in a disguise. Like one of those like glasses with the nose and mustache on or something, like a cartoonish disguise. Appreciate it, CJ. People say the internet lasts forever, but it really doesn't. Shit gets deleted and never re-uploaded. Doesn't feel worth downloading, though. Makes more sense to just find new porn. Yeah, and I understand that argument. Like, because I've been talking about this a lot, why physical media is so important, because everything just keeps getting taken off and you have no ownership over anything. But, like, I feel like the number one thing that you shouldn't care about owning is porn. There's just like an endless abundance of it, so even if your like favorite porno goes down, it's like Hydra, five others take its place. It just doesn't feel worth it. Just find another one. It's not the same, bro. I mean, it's a different video, but I mean, it just, I don't know, it doesn't feel like it's a worthy preservation, a worthy endeavor. Thanks, Risa Bainbot. Worked with a dude who kept a garbage bag full of DVD and VHS pornos in the trunk of his car. He asked me if I wanted to see them. I kindly declined. Oh, you missed out. That would have been what an adventure. What a cool guy. Yeah, I just talked about the internet provider thing. Well, mainly the AT&T thing. I haven't looked too deep into it. I only know, like, the surface level of what happened. Thanks, Resub Flux. My dad has an archive of porn spanning from the 70s to the 2000s. Does he like tell you about it? Is it an achievement he's proud of? I don't know if being the porn oracle is necessarily like noble. I mean, I guess it's kind of cool to an extent, but I feel like anything else would be better. It's a family heirloom. The original Coomer. The patient zero of Coomers. It's his inheritance. Yeah, can you imagine? He sits his son down. Son, one day, this kingdom will all be yours. It's just like the Indiana Jones like warehouse of rows upon rows of VHS and DVDs of the 70s through 2000s porn. Everything the light touches.